people were really smart 70 years ago. They were able to figure out how to do mechanically and hydraulically what we just throw at a computer and hope it works. I don't think they realize how special and unique this place is. The facility itself is called the Orrin W. Nix Low Speed Wind Tunnel. For most of its history, it has just been the low speed wind tunnel. There are only two or three other tunnels in the country like this, and we really are the only ones that I'm aware of that are so engaged in the educational mission of the school that they're attached to. It was initially completed in the middle 1940s, first operated in the middle or late 40s as just a straight tunnel called an open loop tunnel. It would draw air in from the outside and eject it back outside again. Then in the late 50s, it was closed up into the closed loop. The aerospace engineering department here is one of the oldest in the country. And this place has been here almost since the beginning. Driving by on the street, you would just see a big beige tube. We've had just about everybody you can imagine testing aircraft configurations, both military and civilian or commercial type configurations. There may be up to a dozen students working here, mostly undergraduates, but a few graduate students. In fact, one, Grace, is working on the test with UC Davis and NASA, so she really is in charge of the test. I mean, she's designing how the pieces come together, she's operating the test, setting up the equipment, and the staff here is supporting her, but she is in charge.
I've been here for about a year as a research assistant, and I was here for 3 years as an undergraduate research assistant. A&M has a great engineering program. Once I was at A&M, we have amazing aerospace labs, and that really drew me to the aerospace program in the first place. I do particle image velocimetry research, PIV for short. You fill the tunnel with a seeding particle, I use smoke, and then use a laser to highlight those particles, and then two camera flashes to see how the particle moves between the two images. The project in particular that I'm working on is UC Davis wing in conjunction with NASA. We're testing a 7-foot wing with high pressure air going through it to see if that could be a good implementation for commercial aircraft.
What we do is try to determine how will an aircraft or a part of an aircraft, a wing or an airfoil section, react to air flowing over it or vice versa. What will the air do when it encounters this object?
We have a test section. And then the motor that pulls air and it goes around the circuit, which makes it a lot more efficient. And the circuit expands and contracts to get the air to move a little bit faster. And we can hit speeds of about 200 miles an hour with that setup.
Really hard to determine in flight because it's hard to put sensors near the object. It's hard to get it in exactly the right configurations. But if we have total control over how we position something, what its parts are, and we can attach it using some kind of load measuring system, then we can get all the data we would like to off that in a very controlled setting. We've tested all sorts of things. As aerospace engineers, our favorite are aircraft. A test like that will usually take, short ones maybe a week, long ones may take 8 weeks in the wind tunnel. And for those, we'll work with an outside company or some other entity, and they'll send us design files of what the vehicle looks like. And the staff here and the students who work here will take those design files and scale them down to something that can fit in the wind tunnel. We've had cyclists in the wind tunnel. We've done architectural tests. We've tested lots and lots of offshore oil rigs and drill ships. We work a lot with student teams and clubs. We've had golf club manufacturers come in and test the drag of different drivers. Just about anything that's exposed to wind or that moves through the air is within our ability to test and evaluate. Almost all aerospace engineers work with computer simulations rather than wind tunnels. The wind tunnel provides us an opportunity to very quickly test in real air how a particular shape will perform. We can get a lot of data really quickly, whereas with simulation, you can maybe start getting data faster. You don't often trust it until you can match it up to an experiment, and then it takes you maybe longer to proceed through all the different cases. So we often will do many, many, many more cases than a simulation.
Computers lie, but the wind won't lie. If you're gonna put a human inside of it, you want to make sure that you're 100% confident in your results. A wind tunnel is how you actually prove that you're correct. It introduces students to that middle step between actual design and then the aircraft going out to the fleet, whether it's commercial or military. Most students, myself included, didn't know test engineering was that middle step. Now, if they go to designing or if they go to flight test engineering or they go to that last step, they'll know what happens in between and they'll have experience with it. I hope to be in between that stages of designing and actually having that plan go out, if that's flight test or wind tunnel testing, somewhere with a big company like that.
The thing that's made me happy over the last decade is just seeing the number of students who come through here and knowing that in the aerospace engineering curriculum, really every single year students are interacting with us. This place had really been a little bit separate from the rest of the department, and one of the things I'm really proud of is how we've been able to pull this facility, the Nix Tunnel, back into the educational mission of the school and really get a lot more student involvement.